Yo, what's going down, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Once again, Dudes Outdoor, highly appreciated. And we are coming back at you guys with another unboxing, this time for the month of March, y'all. Here it is. Yo, this is for my country, for country, fat, clean, looking good on the hardest, spoke, hardest, doing country shit. Boy, wait on my country, for country, riding happy, them trucks just thumping up. Wait on my country, for country, for country, for country, fat, clean, looking good on the hardest, spoke, hardest, doing country shit. Boy, wait on my country, for country, riding happy, them trucks just thumping up. Wait on my country, for country, for my country, for we blowing hella smoke. Yeah, we wildin' in it, bitch. I don't think they ready for my pockets wrapped up. Don't get smacked up. We have the sack in my hand. Today we're gonna do something a little bit different. We are gonna be doing an on-the-water unboxing, y'all. So we're gonna unbox this bad boy. Hopefully we got some dope baits, as I know they always do, in this box that can help us catch some fish today on this pond that I'm at right now, y'all. So let's bust this bad boy open. Hopefully, like I said, we got some super dope baits. One thing I did want to say is I was reading some of the comments. I've been super busy, y'all, so I haven't been able to respond to everybody. But I was reading over some of the comments, and I seen last month some of the people were not happy with their six-sack. And I totally understand some people are not going to be happy with it. And, man, I totally understand. And sometimes I feel the same way, that we do get some of the same baits in them things. But I'm not going to lie, I don't really complain about it much, because those baits do catch fish at the lakes and the ponds I fish every time. And sometimes I get snagged up, I lose a bait, I let friends borrow baits or whatnot, and I don't get them back. So with that being said, man, I don't mind getting baits that I've already received. I love having more than one of those baits. I actually put them on my wall in the garage and get my bait selection, my bait selection stacked up real nice, y'all. So that's just personally what I like doing. But man, I totally understand when people do not like getting baits that they have already received, and baits they can't even fish in their area, y'all. So with that being said, totally understandable. Let's bust this box open. Hopefully there's something different up in here. Hopefully there's something exclusive, a nice color we could fish with today. And man, let's bust this bad boy open. Let's see what it does. Boom, another dope sack, and this thing looks loaded, man. Check that out. Hopefully this thing is fully loaded with some bait so we can catch some fish today. And if not, I know they're gonna catch me fish in the future. And like I said, if I do get a double of some things, they're gonna go right on my wall, man. And I actually love it when I have extra baits, so I ain't gotta go order none. I go straight to the wall, grab it, tie on, and get back on the water, y'all. So let's get to it. First bait. The first bait we got right here is the Speed Glide and the Threadfin Shad. No, excuse me. Threadfin Flash. Check that out, y'all. Threadfin Flash. This is the Speed Glide by the Six. I've actually thrown this a few times. I have not grown accustomed to throwing this a lot, but since it came in my sack, I'll definitely get out there and pop this thing around right now. And like I said, right now is a good month to be throwing stuff like this, giving it them nice aggressive pops. They're up feeding, coming up shallow, and this right here could be a good bait right here, y'all. Speed Glide. Check that out. Got that feathered hook on the back. Super dope color scheme. I always love them realistic eyes they give us. And I tell you guys that over and over again. Super durable hooks, y'all. Check that out. Color scheme is super dope. Super dope. Got that white belly. And that tail just... that back half right there, it's just swinging around. And this tail right here, that feather hook right there, gives us some nice extra action, y'all. Coming in hot for the month of March, y'all. First bait, Speed Glide in the Threadfin Shad, y'all. Excuse me, Threadfin Flash. Threadfin Flash. And I see movement going on right behind this camera, y'all. Bait number one, month of March, y'all. Let's keep it going. What we got right here, the Mini 25MD. I love this crankbait right here. I love this crankbait. I've actually caught some good fish with this crankbait, not this color, but right now, coming in March, them reds, them oranges, them bright colors are gonna come in real nice, y'all. Check that out. This gets down to like 4 to 9 feet, I believe. Correct. Up 4 to 7 feet. 4 to 7 feet. Smaller profile. The 25 MD coming in hot for the month of March. Y'all check that out. Super dope crawfish pattern. You can never go wrong with that right there. And like I said, right here in March, crawfish are out and bass are feeding, y'all. So check that out. Bait number two coming in hot. We're gonna run through these things pretty quick because I do see a lot of action going on and I don't want to miss it, and I want to be able to give you guys a super dope video today. So hopefully we can make that happen. Bait number two coming in hot, y'all. Coming in hot. Bait number three, what we got? The Quake 80 suspending, y'all. Another super dope bait right here. Lipless crankbait in the shad burst. Super dope shad pattern right here, y'all. Check that out. This is the 80 size. Yep, the Quake 80 suspending. Phone's going off real quick. Let me put that on pause. My bad, y'all. That's my brother right there. We're gonna call you right back, bro. We just gotta show our Dudes Outdoor family out there what we got in this month's sack, y'all. Check it out. So this is a suspending lipless crankbait. Super dope bait right here. This thing right here, most lipless crankbaits you throw out and the first thing they do is sink straight to the bottom. This thing right here is a suspending lipless, y'all. So you throw it out there, it sinks more as you start to reel it and you stop. You're gonna do a lot of stop and pause. You're gonna throw it out, get it down in there, get it down deep, and then you stop. Twitch it a few times, reel it in, stop, reel it in, stop. When you stop, every time you stop, this thing is just gonna pause right there in the water column, y'all. Man, they can't get enough of it. And this color right here, super, super dope. Super dope color. Look at that right there, y'all. That flash on there. It's gonna get their attention. You got that BB sound. You got that BB, and you still got a hard knock in there too. Kind of got the best of both worlds, y'all. So coming in hot for the month of March, bait number three, y'all. The shad burst suspending lipless crankbait. Like I said, this thing suspends. It does not sink straight to the bottom. Throw it out, reel it in. It's gonna start going deeper as you reel it. Stop it. Pause it, twitch it, keep it going, pause it, twitch it, and the whole shebang, y'all. You're gonna get bit real nice with this bad boy right here, y'all. Super dope bait right here. And so far, I'm not gonna lie, I personally am happy with so far with the three baits that I got, because I love this right here. I've caught good fish on here, and this right here makes me wanna get out and fish it more since I have not fished it enough, y'all. So, three baits right there. I'm definitely satisfied with what we got up in here, y'all. We got an Axel Metal 2.0, y'all. Check this out. This is another super dope bait we have received in some of the previous sacks. Another dope bait I have caught fish on, but I definitely want to get out there and start using more. It's pretty much, I would say, the best of both worlds. If you've seen any of my unboxings prior where I talked about this bait, it's pretty much the best of both worlds as far as you're gonna get a crankbait and a chatterbait mixed in one, y'all, because you got this super dope bill right here. Look at this, as I move it back and forth, you see, as I wiggle it, it's moving back and forth. You have this bill right here, check it out. This bill right here goes right back and forth, causing a commotion. Same sound pretty much as close to the same sound as a chatterbait. That chatter that it makes, but you get a crankbait profile like this. And there's you get a knock in there as well. So pretty much this thing moves erratically through the water, y'all. Super erratic through the water, causing a big commotion. Like I said, you're getting the best of both worlds. That nice wobble from the crankbait, but you're also getting that clack from the chatterbait, y'all. That chatter. Super dope bait. Also, in the chartreuse black back, y'all. Chartreuse black back. Super good, super dope bait when you're fishing in the muddy waters after them storms roll in. The back of them creeks could get dirty. This right here could be a super dope color. And with that knock and the sound of that lip, definitely gonna cause some attention. Y'all know coming through this right now. This actually might be a good bait to be thrown today because we got an overcast day, and this water right here is dirty off from the last few days. It's been raining off and on. We've had a few cold fronts come in, so it's been playing with our water, y'all. But coming in hot for the month of March, once again, bait number four, y'all. Check that out. The Axle Metal 2.0 in the Chartreuse Black Bag. Chartreuse Black Bag, baby. Super dope. Also, there's a patent pending on this design that they have here. See that right there? Boom. Patent pending. All right, y'all. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's what we got up in here. Let's go for these soft plastics. The Stroker Crawl Watermelon Candy. Can never go wrong with a Stroker Crawl. Crawfish imitation with that bluegill color. You got them flakes in there. That candy flake. Pretty much got that good old candy paint flake up in there going on, y'all. This thing right here is going to cause a lot of commotion. These little arms right here, you undo the arms. Make sure you undo the arms. These are going to kick a lot of water. You got them little appendages. Super dope bait. You can throw on the back of a hybrid jig. Or you could also throw this as a Texas rig and get the job done, y'all. Look at that super dope candy right there. Super dope color. That's that candy right there, y'all. That good old candy paint. Candy paint sprinkles, y'all. Look at them appendages. Woo, them claws are kicking, baby. Can never go wrong with some Stroker claws in the sack. Let me know what you guys think so far, y'all, for what we got in this month's sack. Like I said, so far, I'm not going to lie, I am pretty happy, even though I have got these baits before. All these baits I do got, I'd be lying to say I don't. I do got them, but I am happy because I get more of them. And sometimes they send me colors that I really wouldn't get on my own. So I get out there and I throw them, and man, sometimes I surprise myself on the fish I catch on colors that I would not normally throw, y'all. So let's keep it going. We got two more things in the sack. And man, we just go ahead and show them both at the same time. We got a Divine Worm Weight. Divine Worm Weight, 1/4. It's a 1/4 ounce. Check that out. And then we got the EWG hooks, size 4 right here, to go with the Stroker claws, y'all. Check that out. So this right here is a super dope setup in itself, y'all. This setup right here, you tie this setup on right here, you're going to get out there and you're going to catch fish regardless, I guarantee you. Texas rig is one of the most classic bass fishing tools that they have out there, y'all. Make sure you guys tie this on. Yeah, get out there and go fishing, y'all. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you guys think of today's unboxing. If you guys are satisfied with it, if you guys are not, if you guys are subscribers, if you guys continue to subscribe, let me know. Y'all talk to me. I talk back. I know last month I failed to respond to some of the comments. Like I said, no hard feelings. I'm just super busy out here, y'all, trying to keep it going. And yeah, with that being said, I will be sure to tap in with you guys when you guys leave me a comment, y'all. So I'm going to get out here. I'm going to fish. I'm going to tie some of these baits on that we got in this month's sack. And hopefully this rest of this video will be super lit for y'all. I hear fish jumping back there. Let's get out there, y'all. Come on. Baby, but he came up and snacked him. Came up and smacked him. Relax, guy. Y'all see it? Not major, but he did come up and smack it. Alright, y'all, we got our first fish on the axle. Threw it right up into there right there, and he came up and smacked it. Hopefully we get them to keep biting this. So that'd be pretty dope. Y'all, we on. I have my charger. Ooh, I had it charging. I had it charging real quick. We are gonna get away from trolling motor. Ooh, we got him, coach. We got him, coach. Yes, sir. Got him, y'all. Yes, sir. Y'all see it. Woo! On that crawl pattern. And I forgot to mention exactly what it was. What was it? It was the boiled crawfish, y'all. Boiled crawfish. Check that out. Whew. Nice one. Feeding up. Look at that little belly. Look at that little belly. Look at that hook set right there, y'all. I mean, I didn't even really have to hook it. He came up and was trying to swallow that whole thing. Came up and got him right there, y'all. Let me go ahead and get a quick picture. And then we're going to release him. All right, y'all. Let's get these hooks up out this fish. Alright, y'all. Let's get this fish back out there. Let's see if we can get this fish to dance for us. See if we can get this fish to dance for us. Got some crawfish in there. Jumped and hooked himself. Yes. Fish. Number two. Fish number three, actually. There it is, y'all. I think we might be onto something. They might be onto this boiled crawfish right here. Hopefully we found him. Seems like right when we pulled up into this area. Got this wind blowing in on this bank too, so. Still came up to munch on it. It's a little guy, come on. We'll play with you for a second. Man. getting it, smacking that back hook. The other one was eating the whole thing. Like that. Yeah, buddy, you might be on something. It's on the pause. I'm hitting it, feeling it hitting the bottom. Oh, I just see something over there go down. Starts to hit the bottom, and I pause it. There's also some brush right here, some fallen timber in the water. All right, y'all, we gotta make something happen with the stroker crawl. See if we can make something shake with the stroker crawl. And then we have the speed gliding, the Quake 80 suspending lipless crankbait. Hopefully we could catch some on all of them. Because this right here will be killing three birds with one stone, because I got the weight, the hook, and the stroker crawl. So if I'm able to do that, then that means I catch a fish on everything that came in the March six sack, y'all. Oh, wasn't recording, baby, but we got him on the stroker crawl, baby. Yes. Right on the stroker crawl. Look at that. You weren't going nowhere, baby. Yes.